Next, we have another past student of Professor Pandit, Mr. Swapnil Paigankar. He has done a master's under Professor Pandit and is currently working in Engineering as an engineer. I don't know about his post actually. So I would like to welcome Mr. Paigankar.
Hello everyone. I'm Swapnil. I'm working with Engineering right now as a specialist in modeling and simulation. Don't consider myself to be qualified to comment anything about Pandit sir's contribution towards chemical engineering, because chemical engineering itself happens to be one of my interests and means of earning my bread and butter right now. I do not consider that entity to be any more as far as my attributes are concerned. But yes, I'll touch upon certain factors that I felt, according to my level of comprehensions, that added value to our lives and gave a kind of direction in terms of how we should lead our lives. I'll tell you something. When I said chemical engineering happens to be one of my interests, I am actually an avid pursuer of classical music, and there is my own set of learning and research that I'm doing in the field of percussion, the Indian percussion. And that also opens one kind of dimension of understanding the Guru Shishya Parampara. That is also kind of a common thread between what we do here in UDCT. And I see many people talking about their guru, or the line of gurus, or the lineage as such, touching the ear lobes all the time. Given the fact that the kind of nature that I am made up of, outspoken, most of the time inconvenient, I consider that particular action to be finding the easy way out. That's the easy way out. My guru was great. Okay. What's so great about him? Because we don't want to think, we don't want to pursue. So, doing an analysis of why Pandit sir was great, for that matter, why Vilayat Khan was great, why Ahmad Jah Thirakwa was great, they were not just great, they were great for a reason. They pursued a particular fundamental or principle of life and they followed it, no matter what the consequences are. What I find very interesting about Professor Pandit, our guru, is the way his students developed. Everybody that we see, the last time we met was a meet that happened on the lawn, the ABP meet, and sir said a few times ago, every time we don't have to meet often, the new meeting is a continuation of the old one. So that tradition kind of continues. Everybody is unique. We are not the copies or the molds of our professor. That itself is the credit of this great man. He let us express our individualities, whatever we did in this institute, and we carried that particular thought and expressed it in our professional lives or personal lives. Many of us are wise enough to understand it. I remember he had a peculiar way of dealing with every student. One particular stingy remark that he particularly wrote on my paper when I gave it for a review, and I mentioned it last time as well. I was back from National Institute of Oceanography doing some research on vortex diode and microbial disinfection of seawater, and I wrote the entire chapter on results and discussions, and he just mentioned one particular line, no marks, no red markups. He just mentioned, prolonged exposure to biologists has made, I'm afraid prolonged exposure to biologists has turned you up into one. Start thinking like a chemical engineer. Nothing more. It took me a couple of weeks to rephrase everything. And so he knew what you are. He knew how you thought. And he knew. In Chris Marathi, we said, Ta varna tagbhat kunala kadato, he guru la kadato. I realized all of these things 10 years after I passed out from his lab. And on a personal level, this has given me confidence to pursue interest, to pursue a thought, or to pursue principles in my personal life. Thanks a lot for enriching our lives. Thank you.